Welcome to EPG Patishala. I am Ravi Kori Setter, Senior Fellow, Dr. V.S. Wakankar Archaeological Research Institute, Bhopal. In the subject of Indian culture and paper 2 on pre and proto-historic cultures of India, in this particular presentation, I will be outlining the basic concepts in prehistory. As an introduction to the entire paper, this particular presentation has been divided into four sections. Section 1 deals with the earliest evidence of humans and associated tools in the form of a general introduction. Section 2 deals with the periodization in prehistory and tool types that characterize each of these subdivisions of Stone Age and subsequent cultural periods. Section 3 deals with molecular archaeology, which is the most recent development in the field of human prehistory, dealing with the evidence of preservation of ancient DNA in the fossil hominin remains. Section 4 briefly deals with colonization events in prehistory. Objectives. This chapter introduces basic terms that frequently occur in the later chapters. Paleoanthropological information regarding the evolution of humankind is described according to the taxonomic nomenclature, including the binomial systems. The genus and species names are mentioned, as in the case of Homo erectus. Homo refers to genus, erectus refers to species, meaning the human who stood upright or a bipedal human. The term Homo refers to the genus and erectus, the species it represents. Homo habilis and Homo erectus and later human ancestors were tool makers and were the authors of culture. The origin and development of culture, that is human behavior, is traced through the stone tools that were made, used and discarded by human ancestors. Therefore, the chapter introduces the basic terminologies as well as periods during which time technologies evolved from the simple to the more and more complex, that is during the Stone Age. The African paleoanthropological record provides the oldest and the most continuous fossil record of both apes and human ancestors. In section 1 of this chapter, a brief account of various fossil beginning from pre-Australopithecines to anatomically moderns, including recent paleoanthropological discoveries and issues relating to their long survival, are discussed. Humans are given in the next two chapters. Section 2 of this chapter gives an outline of periodization in prehistory and distinctive tool types. Lithic technology and typology is dealt with in detail in separate modules. Section 3 introduces the new field of inquiry into the human past through a study of ancient genes preserved in the fossils, now a major endeavor called molecular archaeology. This field of study has enriched our understanding of the dispersal of ancient human populations out of Africa. Of course, there are ongoing debates. Current research on human origins addresses two important questions: A. When and B. Where exactly the origins took place, possessing distinctive behavioral traits in comparison with the great apes. Another important concern of anthropologists is what factors were responsible for the peopling of the world. A. Is this because of origins took place in one geographical region and spread worldwide through dispersal? Or B. The origins took place in multiple regions. The story of human origins and development is built upon two sets of evidence: A. Fossil record and B. Archaeological evidence of human behavior. The illustrations here give you a brief idea of the migration out of Africa and the various types of human ancestors that have been located in Eastern Africa, and the age of human ancestors known to us so far from the paleoanthropological record are also shown here. The archaeological record of human behavior begins with the oldest evidence of stone tools. These have been found in East Africa, particularly in the Old Wai Gorge, and these are simple stone artifacts made from pebbles and cobbles of stone by removing flakes from the edge of the pebbles to achieve a sharp cutting edge. Such tools are called choppers and chopping tools. Such tools were found for the first time in the region of Old Wai Gorge in East Africa, particularly the Kenyan region. These simple stone artifacts were associated with the earliest human ancestor known as Homo habilis. The available geochronological methods have enabled dating the human ancestor fossils and placing the oldest of them in Africa. Some of the oldest fossils to date are represented by Sahelanthropus chadensis, or Tumai. It was found in Central Africa's Chad region. The region is shown on the map here. This has been dated to about 6 to 7 million years ago. This has a flat cranial base indicating that it was perhaps a biped. Another equally old, 6 million year old fossil human ancestor is known as Ororin tugenensis from Eastern Africa. Therefore, East Africa has remained the focus of study of human prehistory, and many fossil discoveries that have enriched our understanding of human biocultural evolution come from this region. In the following, some of the famous fossils are described. Ardipithecus ramidus. This is a bipedal hominin. More than 100 specimens have been recovered from several different parts in Afar province of Ethiopia in eastern Africa. This is dated to about 4.4 million years ago. This was a tall, capable of climbing tree and is said to have been possessing a vegetarian diet and lived in woodland ecosystems. There is no evidence of tool making as yet. Ardipithecus ramidus is tentatively believed to be ancestral to Australopithecus, but it is a million years older than Lucy, that is Australopithecus afarensis, which is dated to about 3.7 million years ago, and older than Australopithecus anamensis, which is dated to about 3.9 million years ago. Both the latter were not tool makers. Australopithecus is one of several pre-Homo species of hominins. It is not known if this was a direct ancestor of Homo erectus. Fossils of Australopithecus have been found in Africa, dating to the period between 4.2 and 1.4 million years ago. They are known to have used tools, if not made tools. They walked upright on two legs and had a long forearm and lumbar column relative to African or Asian apes, stood between 1.2 to 1.5 meters and had a body mass of 30 to 35 kg and a brain size between 350 and 600 cc's, with an average brain size of 440 cc's. Paleoanthropologists recognize seven species of the genus Australopithecus. The following are some of the fossils found in different parts of Africa. They come from well-dated contexts. Genus Homo. Major discoveries of fossils of the genus Homo are reported from Eastern Africa, and the oldest is dated to around 2.5 million years ago. Its emergence opened up a new chapter in human evolution, as this has survived on the surface of the earth longer than any other antecedent or contemporary species by virtue of capability to produce tools accompanied by expansion of brain, superior cognition, and technological innovations. In the general scheme of human evolution, the genus Homo is divided into three successive species, Homo habilis, Homo erectus, and Homo sapiens, with a couple of variants such as Homo heidelbergensis and Homo neanderthalensis. Homo habilis. This human ancestor was the first tool maker and was therefore called handyman. But more recent evidence is indicating tool making to predate Homo habilis. The pre-Homo stone tools are dated to around 3 million years ago. There is clear evidence about them being put to use by the maker. Homo habilis lived in eastern southern Africa between 2.4 and 1.4 million years ago. The fossil remains were first discovered in Olduvai Gorge in Tanzania, and the associated tools were called Oldovan tools. Homo habilis has a slightly larger brain case, smaller teeth, and moderate protrusion of lower jaw. Comparison with Australopithecus. Stands up to 4.5 feet with an average brain size of 400 cc's. The succeeding Homo erectus lived in Africa between 1.8 million years and 250,000 years ago. It was the first hominin to move out of Africa. Homo erectus was both heavier and taller than Australopithecus and a more efficient walker with an average brain size of about 820 cc's. They were the first humans with a projecting nose, and their skulls were long and low with large brow ridges. The following are some of the well-known sites in Old World. The details about these examples from across the Old World can be seen in the e-text. And here are some examples of Homo erectus fossils, particularly the cranial remains coming from different parts of Africa. Homo neanderthalensis were a type of early hominin that lived on the planet Earth between about 200,000 1000 to 30,000 years ago. Our immediate ancestor, anatomically modern humans, has been in evidence for roughly 130,000 years ago. In some places, Neanderthals coexisted with modern humans for about 10,000 years, and it is possible that the two species may have interbred. Recent mitochondrial DNA studies at the site of Fellofer Cave suggest that Neanderthals and humans had a common ancestor about 550,000 years ago, but are not otherwise related. Nuclear DNA on a bone from Windija Cave supports this supposition, although the time depth is still in question. However, the Neanderthal Genome Project appears to have settled the issue, uncovering evidence that some modern humans hold a tiny percentage of Neanderthal genes. Homo sapiens. Early modern humans possessed an average male height of 170 centimeters and 168 centimeters, an average female height of about 157 centimeters and 158 centimeters. Where were these early modern human sites are located? In Africa, early modern humans appeared at least as long ago as 200,000 years ago. The oldest evidence comes from two sites such as Bauri in Ethiopia and Omo Kibish in Ethiopia. The earliest sites outside of Africa are at Skul and Kafre caves in Israel, dating back to 100,000 years ago. There is a large gap in the record for Asia and Europe between 100,000 and 40,000 years ago, a period in which the Southwest Asia seems to have been occupied by Neanderthals. But around 50,000 years ago, the anatomically modern humans appear again and expanded into Europe. Their presence in Israel suggests that they occupied a much wider geographical area. Their presence within and outside of Africa is the basis of conflicting dispersal models currently debated by archaeologists and geneticists. In recent past, a distinctive hominin site in Siberia was discovered, where the human remains from Denisova have received considerable attention from both geneticists as well as archaeologists. The only remains of Denisovans identified to date are two teeth and a small fragment of finger bone from level 11 at Denisova Cave, a level dated between 29 to 48,000 years ago, and containing a variant of initial Upper Paleolithic cultural remains found in Siberia called Altai. Discovered in the year 2000, these fragmentary remains have been the target of molecular investigations since 2008. In March 2010, one of the small fragments, a phalanx of a child aged between 5 and 7 and found within level 11 of Denisova Cave, received much attention. What we know about the culture of the Denisovans is that it was apparently not much different from other initial Upper Paleolithic populations in the Siberian north. The stone tools in the layers in which the Denisovan human remains were located are a variant of Mousterian, with the documented use of parallel reduction strategy for the cores and a large number of tools formed on large blades. We come to the second section, wherein we briefly explain the concept of periodization in prehistory. The Old Stone Age, known as the Paleolithic period in human prehistory, is the name given to the period between 2.5 million years and 20,000 years ago. Today, scholars divide the Paleolithic into three categories as follows. Lower Paleolithic, also known as Early Stone Age. The Lower Paleolithic lasted between 2.5 million years to 200,000 years ago, and it was when the hominin ancestors of human beings, including Australopithecus, Homo habilis, Homo erectus, and Homo ergaster, roamed most of Africa and Eurasia and began making the first tools and gradually moved out of Africa. Middle Paleolithic, also African Middle Stone Age. The Middle Paleolithic witnessed the evolution of Neanderthals and the first anatomically modern Homo sapiens, and some of the first glimmers of modern behavior, sophisticated stone tools, caring for the elderly, hunting and gathering, and some amount of symbolic or ritual behavior is associated with this time period. Upper Paleolithic, also African Late Stone Age. By the Upper Paleolithic times, that is around 45,000 years ago to 10,000 years ago, the Neanderthals were replaced by then by modern humans. Homo sapiens spread all over the planet. The Late Stone Age is characterized by fully modern behaviors such as cave art, hunting, and making a wide range of tools in stone, bone, ivory, and antler. The Upper Paleolithic was a period of great transition in the world. prehistoric tools and periods, the Lower Paleolithic. The Lower Paleolithic period, also known as the Early Stone Age, is currently believed to have lasted between about 2.7 to 200,000 years ago. It is the first archaeology that is to say that period when first evidence of what scientists consider human behaviors occurred. The Lower Paleolithic begins when the first known stone tool manufactured occurred about 2.7 million years ago, called the Oldowan tradition. Stone tools of the Lower Paleolithic also include Acheulean hand axes and cleavers. These suggest that most humans of the period were scavengers rather than hunters. Lower Paleolithic sites are characterized by the presence of extinct animal types dated to early and middle Pleistocene. The Middle Paleolithic, also known as Middle Stone Age. The Middle Paleolithic period, lasting between 200,000 years to 40,000 years ago, is the period during which archaic humans, including Homo sapiens and Neanderthalensis, appeared and flourished all over the world. Hand axes continued in use, but a new kind of stone toolkit was created called the Mousterian. It included purposefully prepared cores and specialized flake tools. The living method in the Middle Paleolithic, or both Homo sapiens and our Neanderthal cousins, included scavenging, but there is also clear evidence of hunting and gathering activities. Here are some of the tools invented by both anatomically modern humans and Neanderthals, as well as the invention of Levallois technology. Tools of the Upper Paleolithic. Stone tools of the Upper Paleolithic were primarily based on blade technology. Blades are stone pieces that are twice as long as they are wide and generally have a parallel side. They were used to create an astonishing range of formal tools, tools created to specific widespread patterns with specific purposes. In addition, bone, antler, shell, and wood were used to a great degree for both artistic and working tool types, including the first eyed needles, presumably for making clothing about 21,000 years ago. Here are some of the tools of both bone and stone, as well as microblades, backed blades, and so on. Molecular archaeology and dispersal. Questions such as who were our ancestors, where did they originate from, which migratory route they followed during the course of peopling of the world, and how did they live in varying climatic conditions now seem to have arrived at resolute answers as a result of development of molecular archaeology. The discipline deals with fossil genes preserved in fossil hominin specimens, ancient mitochondrial DNA and Y chromosome non-recombining can be extracted with precision, and they have become important tools in the study of prehistoric human evolution and reconstruction of migration patterns. In addition to these datasets have become tools for testing theories of modern human evolution and expansion out of Africa, including the paths of dispersal and timing of dispersal. While molecular archaeology deals with mitochondrial DNA sequence and Y chromosome in ancient and modern populations, dispersal refers to geographic and temporal origins of humans. In spatial and temporal distribution of human populations across the planet Earth, while earlier models of dispersal were based on fossils and archaeological parameters, in terms of measurable morphological similarities and differences between fossils and stone tool assemblages, the coming of genetics had added higher precision, higher resolution to the ongoing debate. Colonization during the Lower Paleolithic. Homo erectus populations expanded out of Africa into other parts of the Old World during Lower and Middle Pleistocene times. Modern humans colonized Australia and the Americas by the end of the Upper Paleolithic and moved into hitherto unexploited regions such as deserts and tundras. There is ongoing debate about the origins and spread of modern humans. One school advocated recent African origins of modern humans, and the other school argues for in-situ development of modern humans from archaic populations. In this presentation, we have tried to provide basic information about various terminologies and the types of human ancestral fossils, as well as types of stone tools that were made from earliest times to recent past. The stone tool terminology includes the use of terms such as Oldowan, Acheulean, Mousterian, Levallois, backed blades, microblades, and so on and so forth. This series of stone tools belong to distinctive time periods from the earliest to most recent past. By the end of the Upper Paleolithic, the use of distinctive varieties of raw materials occurring in distinctive geographical areas also came to be exploited by expanding hominin populations. The paleoanthropological record very clearly reveals the fact that the oldest evidence of human ancestor who invented stone tools is very well preserved in African continent, particularly in the regions of East Africa, and the evidence from Tanzania and Kenya is the oldest so far when it comes to identifying the earliest stone tool maker. The earliest stone tool maker has been identified as Homo habilis, and then the Homo habilis was succeeded by Homo erectus, the human ancestor who invented hand axes and cleavers, followed by the evolution of modern humans and contemporary Homo neanderthalensis. Interestingly, it is observed that while Homo sapiens spread across the entire world over a period of time, Neanderthals were largely restricted to Europe and did not evolve further and reach an evolutionary dead end. In recent years, the relationship between multiple varieties of human ancestral species is being studied through an entirely new technique known as mitochondrial DNA and Y chromosome analysis of ancient human remains coming from different parts of the world. And this area of research is contributing very precise information about the origin and spread of human populations from a single center, and that being Africa. For more details, I would like to recommend you to consult eText. Thank you.